Thank you so much, Zoe. Well, it is indeed World Youth Skills Day. We are celebrating that, and we have a few essential kitchen skills to show you to take your cooking skills to the next level. An award-winning afternoon espresso chef, Chef Tumi, now joins us in the Expresso kitchen to show us how to elevate your kitchen game, yeah?
Basically.
Because as a chef, there are a couple of standards, things that you're going to be called to do often that you really need to know, and a couple of things that are going to just raise the game. I'm very excited about learning how to emulsify, so that's why I'm here this morning, why I have an apron on. But maybe let's start with an egg. Poaching an egg has got to be one of those things that you're almost judged by as
yes,
a chef.
Definitely. And I know that it's mainly for chefs, but it is important with us being home nowadays
yeah,
to try and impress we're all our
cooking.
Loved ones.
We're all cooking.
So why not? So what you've just seen me add in there was some vinegar, right? Whenever you're poaching, it's important to always have an acidic ingredient in there. So we've got some water that's been boiling. We're now bringing it down to a simmer because in essence, you don't want the egg to break.
And the boiling water, all that turmoil is gonna, okay.
Right, in school we were taught to make a whirlpool, but I just want to show you a different way. So in essence, what you do is you make a whirlpool in the center of the liquid.
And that centrifugal force then keeps the egg together. Okay,
perfect.
Science.
And whenever I make poached eggs, I always suggest that you use the freshest of eggs. The reason for that is because, you've got the yolk and the albumen, the white part, the egg white. As long as your egg is fresh, it still holds its shape. The older it gets, the more saturated it gets. So in this instance,
that's a hack within a hack. So use fresh eggs, okay?
Use fresh eggs. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to try and drop it into the center of the liquid, of the water, and then just let it do its thing. You don't want your water to be bubbling at this point. All you just want the water to be hot enough. It's come up to temperature, it started boiling. I'm gonna slowly just increase the heat, but just leave it now.
You don't want the bubbles.
You don't want the bubbles, because that also forces
that's
the
gonna
egg
break
all over
the egg.
Place. So while we ignore that baby, do its thing, we're gonna get on to a next step.
Okay.
Another trick.
Another one.
People struggle with this.
Okay.
You want to open your avo, you wanna make sure it's good. First step, make sure you've got a sharp knife. And not all of us have knife sharpeners at home. You don't
for
have those
sure.
mechanics where you're like a swordman in the kitchen. So just take a cup, any mug at home. The bottom
okay,
of it,
so any ceramic mug.
Any ceramic mug.
Wow.
Even a side plate, even a plate, the bottom.
If it's got that rough ceramic edge.
Correct.
Okay, cool.
And all you do is just run your knife along on the edge there.
Oh, wow.
That helps to sharpen your knife.
It's so funny because I've got a ceramic knife sharpener at home.
Oh, look at you.
So,
you've got fancy stuff.
You
I don't even
see.
Have that.
wow, I could have been using my cup the whole time. Okay, that's brilliant.
Yeah, and that's it. And you just sharpen it this is quite sharp. So, that's in essence the trick. And then to make sure you get your avos, like some people do it on a surface, this is how I prefer to do it, where you just cut the avo in half.
Wow, look at our. This is like a ninja blade here.
And then separate the two halves. There you got your avo open. But now you need to get this little baby out. Trick, make sure it's a big knife as well, because these ones don't have the space. So your knife, just hack it.
Karate chop.
There's
Boom.
Your center out. And then we
And it's also quite a satisfying feeling to go.
Definitely. I feel like a ninja whenever I do
these
kind of
things. Yeah,
exactly. And then we obviously want to make sure we serve people some avo. And if you're making slices, I usually use the back of the knife and not the front. Because
okay.
you might end up cutting yourself. So all I do is the back of my knife.
Because a ripe, soft avo, you should be able to kind of
Correct.
Play through that anyway.
And
okay.
if it's too soft and you use the other end, you might cut yourself, which we're trying to avoid. And then make some.
I am a cut risk in the kitchen. I have done it many times.
This is why we've got your whisking duty, my
darling. I know. I'll probably find a way to use this whisk to hurt myself.
Please don't.
No, I won't. I love that. Brilliant. Sharp
awesome.
Knife. Brilliant. Egg. Brilliant. Please, can you teach me how to emulsify?
Emulsification.
I want to emulsify.
Right. In your bowl, you've got an egg yolk.
Okay.
Right next to that, you've got some red wine vinegar, you've got some salt and some mustard. And whenever
okay.
you're making a mayo or emulsifying something, it is also important to have some acidic element there.
Okay.
So in this instance, you can add all the ingredients
all of these.
Besides the oil.
Okay.
And then whisk it up. What you're trying to do is you want to make sure they, in essence, become like a slurry, like a sauce of sorts. But it's going to be very liquid.
Can
but
I use
now,
your...
in order
okay,
to
no,
add.
That's fine. That's
in order on. To make it thicken, we want to make sure we add our oil gradually. You don't want to plop it all in at once. So whisk it in first, whisk it all together first. First step, all the babies together.
Mix.
That
cool.
is it. So you can use an egg yolk, you can use the full egg, it's completely up to you.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, I normally just use the egg yolk, but the egg also works perfectly. It's just up
to you. Is that mixed enough?
That's perfect. And then you can now add your oil. In fact, let me do this. Let me add the oil.
And okay. The and then I can do the whisking. Cool.
Yes, and you just gradually add it, but you make sure you whisk it. And then the harder you whisk, the more you keep whisking, the more the mouth flies. Can I just ask you to show our viewers exactly what we're talking about now?
That.
It's getting thicker.
Look
so the
beautiful,
more
creamy and wonderful that is.
Perfect. So the more oil you add, the thicker it gets. So depending on where you whether you want a thick consistency or runny, that is in essence it.
Oh, it's come to. I thought it was going to like fail and I was going to look like an absolute idiot. No. But this is
I'm here to make
amazing.
You look like a star.
I know. Because you are reward winning and a superstar. Look at that. I just made mayonnaise. Amazing. That is so cool. If you want to create your own mayonnaise, pick up any of these tips, you can go to expressoshow.com. We have all of our culinary inspiration there. Well, after the break, we're going to get to meet the man behind the award-winning food truck, Alexander Tarao. And, of course, Alex is someone that Tumi's eyes, look at her eyes, light up with fire. It is the arch nemesis, but he is a great guy and an incredible chef, and we'll meet him in just a moment.